Welcome to Sylvan Hills, Arkansas, Sherwood, Arkansas, Sylvan Hills High School, the Newport Greyhounds, the Road Warriors, second of three in a row on the hills to play a very talented Sylvan Hills Bears football team. David Black, Randy Klepeczka, Dan Klepeczka, Shane Hutchinson.
For the Greyhounds,
we're at a beautiful, beautiful facility. Bullard, new AstroTurf, Randy, they're breaking it in tonight for their home game.
Yeah, tonight's the dedication night, so a bunch of dignitaries 49. Are going to be here. I was really surprised when I got to the parking lot just how many people are here, and the stands are, you know, three-fourths full at least over there. So they're excited about tonight. You know, they're kind of like us. They've been on the road two straight weeks. We'll be on the road three straight weeks. So they're ready to break the stadium in tonight.
Randy, let's talk a little bit about this Sylvan Hills football team.
Number 49 was Tony Stafford.
Season.
For Sylvan Hills, your captains are
no doubt these guys can score.
Yeah, they can score. They've got a lot of speed, a lot of athletic ability. They beat Bologna in the first game 41-18 last week, a shootout, a score fest. They beat Lakeside 48-35. So there's no doubt they can score a lot of points. They seem to give up a lot of points as well, so it could be one of those shootouts tonight.
Yeah, we have to apologize. We're right under the speaker once again, and it's a very loud speaker. Great crowd on hand for Sylvan Hills. The Newport fans are still piling in, and I've seen several people in from the Little Rock, North Little Rock area that live down here. They get to attend a lot of football games that are here. We thank those folks for being here to support the Hounds. It's a quality football team that we're playing tonight, but we're also a quality football team too.
Absolutely, we're a good one too. You know, this series has been really good the last couple of years. You know, last time we were here, we had thunderstorms, a delay in the game. We dominated the first half. I think we led 14-0 at the half. They came back and scored 17 in the second half, won on a pretty long field goal to win the football game. Last year, they came to Newport, and we won pretty convincingly 30-13. So this is a couple of teams that play good football games every year, it seems like, and I don't think this year will be any exception.
Our pregame show each and every Friday night, as we show it to you on Saturday morning, Sunday night, or Tuesday night, is brought to you by Arkansas Steel Associates at 2803 Van Dyke Road. Their phone number is 523-3693. And we thank those guys. You know, they're an economic leader for many years in Newport and Jackson County, and always getting.
And here come the Greyhounds.
Especially here at Cable Channel 15 TV. And just a real quick note, we want to invite everybody. Congratulations to you, my friend, on your retirement. Randy Klepeczka, there's going to be a retirement reception in Randy's honor on Sunday, October the 5th at the Newport Economic Development Commission and Business Resource Center. You know where they're located, on Hazel Street in Newport. The reception is going to be from 1:30 to 3, and a special presentation will take place about 2 p.m. So, you know, you did this for 26 years, a little bit longer than you've been with me, my friend, a long time.
Been a long time, 26 years in Jackson County, 32 overall in extension service, 6 years up in Randolph County at Pocahontas, so, you know, kind of mixed emotions. I'm going to miss a lot of the people I work with, but certainly, you know, time to do something a little bit different, so certainly excited about
start
that.
Start the game, the Bears
what
will
I
be kicking
is,
off, and they will be defending the West Bowl.
I was lucky. I was lucky to get in on the civil service retirement system, so it's a pretty good system. And luckily, if I would have started work about a year later, I wouldn't be on that system.
Wow.
So fortunately,
wow.
I'm old. If I was a couple years younger, I wouldn't be on that. So,
congratulations, my friend.
Thank you, sir.
We're excited. Steve and Stacy Headley, one of our Greyhound boosters, I saw them here tonight. Came over just a short drive for those guys. They live in the Pulaski County area, and we thank them for coming in. I know they watched the game. Got a couple of good emails this week, and we'll talk more about those here in just a little bit. We're just about ready to go. Sylvan Hills to kick off, and my tag team partner, Randy Klepeczka.
The Bears to kick it off, the first kickoff for senior high on this new field. Charlie Bell and Roddy deep for Newport. Kick will be fielded by Roddy at the 15, 20. Roddy still got room. He'll get outside. Roddy at the 40. Roddy 45, 50. In Sylvan Hills territory at the 49-yard line, first and 10, Newport.
Kickoff is returned by number two, Logan Hands, for the Greyhounds. Finally wrestled down by number six, Romello Jones, for the Bears.
Hey,
looks like the Greyhounds will set up shop first and 10.
And about the Bears,
49-yard line.
Use that speed, and they said it was Logan Gann. And Scotty's not even here to watch the game tonight, so he's missing it. They're using last year's roster, obviously.
Obviously.
Gunner straight back. Pump fakes, throws it deep for Charlie. Incomplete. Hounds trying to go deep on first down. Great coverage. Two guys down there for Sylvan Hill. Second and 10, Newport.
Looks like cover two and secondary. What's that
mean? And that'll bring up second and 10.
Get on the wide receivers, then they have safeties over the top, which means there's two safeties back there, so it's actually double coverage on one split receiver.
Hounds two tight end look. Kyron Stafford on the left side, Colton on the right side. One receiver each way. Carl Turner starts in the backfield beside Gunner. Hand off to Carl. Cuts back. Carl still runs hard. He'll be up to the 42. Gain of seven. Sets up second, to third, and three.
Trying to see if big Nick Murphy, who came off the line.
Tackles led by number 24, Tyler Davis for the Bears.
Shoving up there, and that's a good job by Nick firing off. Of course, Hayden Schultz is our center. And Bowen at right guard.
We'll say gain of about 7 yards on the play. That's going to bring up third and about three.
Statler over to right side.
Statler and Cordray Whitmore have been switching off the first couple of plays. Third and three. Gunner straight back. Throws it. Incomplete. It'll be fourth down and three. We'll see what the Hounds do here in Sylvan Hills territory.
Bullard's pass is intended for number 35. Colton Willis falls incomplete.
And that'll
bring up fourth and about three.
Split out about 4 or 5 yards. Brings up a punting situation for the Hounds, and I like this.
Absolutely. Field position. You want to control field position, especially early in the game. Hounds will punt. Charlie Bell to punt. And Zach Alton will deep snap tonight. Will Golden out this week. So, of course, Zach got all the experience last year, so feel confident with him deep snapping.
Tyler Asher also out once again this week with his concussion.
Good snap. Good kick by Charlie. Be fielded at the nine. It goes to the left and be run out of bounds, probably somewhere around the 20-yard line. They're looking for a flag.
That was returned by number 7, Nathan Thomas, for the Bears.
I saw
I believe that stop was made
out
by number 34, Denver Smith, for the Greyhounds. There is a flag.
There's an extra 15 over there, and we don't need that. That'll give them excellent field position.
Penalty was a dead ball personal foul.
If you'd known that was going to happen, you'd go for it, but not supposed
that'll
to happen.
15 yards on to the end of the return.
Well, we had them pinned deep. And 15-yard penalty is going to bring it out in pretty decent field position.
They'll spot it probably somewhere around the 37, 38, 36. Well, only 6 yards effective punt after all that.
Their own 36-yard line.
First and 10, Sylvan Hills. They've got an outstanding quarterback, Trey Doss. Like Gunner, this is his third straight year to start. A lot of good athletes on this football team.
And these guys can score points, as you talked about in the pregame.
Quarterback keeps inside. Played well by the Hound defense. See Roddy, Warsham, and others. No gain on the play. May have lost one. Second down, a long 10 for Sylvan Hills.
Ball carrier was number 32, Fred Williams, up the gut for the Bears. Stop was made by a team meeting of the Greyhound defense. We'll say no gain on the play. It'll bring up second and 10.
Second and 10. Dare say there will not be an inside handoff on this play. We'll see. Comes this way. They block it well. We can't spread it out, and they'll have a good gain. We'll see what the spot is. He'll have a first down at about the 48-yard line. Gain of 12, first and 10, Sylvan Hills.
And that's just a read play there.
He is forced out of bounds by number 34, Denver Smith, for the Greyhounds.
Got past
that play was good enough for a Sylvan Hills first down. Ball will be spotted. First and 10, Bears.
Secondary
to the 48-yard line.
Ball game last week. Darren Roddy in the secondary. Charlie Bell.
Doss keeps it, and he gets out of the trouble, and he's got a long field ahead of him. Good tackle by the Hounds about the 36-yard line. It was Ben Collier on the tackle, or otherwise it could have been six.
Finally wrestled down by number 10, Ben Collier, for the Greyhounds. That play was good enough for another Sylvan Hills first down. Ball will be spotted. First and 10 Bears. How about the Greyhounds? 36-yard line.
They're moving it very, very effectively on their first drive. 9:03 to play here in the first quarter.
First and 10 at the 36. Doss hands off inside. Played well by the Hounds. He'll get about 3 to the 33-yard line. Second and 7, Sylvan Hills.
I think that was Karen from his linebacker position.
Ball carrier was number 32, Fred Williams, for the Bears.
These guys are big up front. 300-pound center.
Stop was made by number 49,
left guard.
Greg Stafford, for the Greyhounds. We'll say gain of about 3 yards on the play. That'll bring up second and 7.
Second and 7. I'm looking for a big night from those Greyhound linebackers tonight. Could be the difference. Stafford and Willis. Option this way. Doss has got room. He pitches it. He run out of bounds. He'll be very near first down. Depends on the spot, and he's right on the marker. I think he will have a first down. Again, they're looking at it. First down, Sylvan Hills at the Newport 26-yard line.
By number 3, that's McCain Ordell right for the Greyhound. Looks like that play was good enough for another pair of first down. Ball be spotted. First and 10 Bears. How about the Greyhound? 26-yard line.
And linebackers have a lot to do with that, too.
First and 10 at the Newport 26. Motion to the left. Doss nearly drops the snap, hands off inside to 32, and he'll have a gain of about 8 inside the Newport 20 to the 18-yard line. Second down and 2, Sylvan Hills. We have 8:08 to go here in the first quarter. There is no score.
Stop was made by number 30, Keith Worsham, for the Greyhounds. Gave about 8 on the play. Bring up second and a long 2.
Hand off to 32, and he's going to go score. Number 32.
Williams off tackle. Take it on.
With an 18-yard touchdown.
Coming in, we thought both teams would score a lot of points tonight. These guys weren't going to be shut out by anybody. So what you got to do, you got to match them. You have to match them each and every offensive series because it's a quality 5A football team.
It's like another soccer player kicking is for the third straight week for the opponent. Ball's down, kicks up in the air. It is good.
That's the point attempt by number 20.
Sylvan Hills 7, Newport 0.
You can
and
buy
with 7:52 left in the first quarter, you're scoring now. The Sylvan Hills Bears 7 and the Newport Greyhounds 0.
They need a great big order. They need a probably need to go by and make your order, and they'll cook it up for you fresh. Come back and get it about 15 or 20 minutes. Well, they've always got a lot of good chicken. It is simply the best in town. Fried chicken at its best at Newport Shell on Highway 367 North. Robert Turner, 1420 McLean Street. Edward Jones Investments for Wise Investments for long-term hometown service. Robert Turner,
5-2-3-8-7-80.
I watched another game this week that he played in. Go back to that year 2000.
Charlie Bell.
Great stretch run for the Hounds, and he was a big part of it.
Yeah, that was a fun year. I remember late in the year, and big victory over Batesville.
They had to drive the length of the field to win it.
Yeah. Sylvan Hills to kick off. Once again, Roddy, who had the outstanding return on the first return, past midfield. Charlie Bell also deep. High kick. Caught by Roddy at the 15. Roddy 20. Got room again. Won't be able to get outside this time, though. And he was still fighting and lost yardage of fighting, but he'll be down around the 21-yard line after being up near the 28. First and 10, Newport.
Newport has to put together some positive offensive plays and some first
initial
down
contact was
change.
Made by number 32, Fred Williams,
first quarter,
and cleaned up by a whole host of Bears. Looks like the ball will be spotted. First and 10, Greyhounds.
In Sam Bowen at one of the guards. Nick Murphy
second
at the
their own 23-yard line.
His spot at the 23-yard line, first and 10, Newport. Oh, there's a flag on the play. Block in the back against Newport, and we're starting out in the hole inside the 13-yard line. 87 yards to go.
Wow.
Hounds did not get a first down on their first drive. Got to sustain some first downs. At least keep running the clock. And off Turner, Carl runs over a guy, runs hard up to about the 18, gain of nearly 5 on the play. Second and 5, Newport.
For the Greyhounds,
going to play 9 guys up and around and near the box, which simply means near the line of scrimmage. And
stop was made by number 3, D'Angelo Bell.
Throw
well, with number 13, Tyler Reeves for the Bears.
Second down and 5.
About 5 yards on the play. It'll bring up second and 5.
Gunner throws it out in the flat. First down, Newport and Moore. 35-40 down at the 43-yard line. Who was that, Elston?
Was complete to number 15.
Elston trying to see if he got the block over there on that side.
Finally, wrestled down from behind by number 31, Jordan Washington for the Bears.
Elston with a big week last week, 7 receptions for 132 yards, picks up where he left off.
Gets a break, Darren Vickers into the football game, 3 wide on the right side.
Inside handoff, Turner. He'll get about five more.
Ball carrier was number 20.
Just past the 47-yard line. We'll call it second and five. Newport, 6:45 to go here in the first quarter. Hounds trail 7-0.
Quickly.
We'll say game about 5 yards on the play.
Customized vision care in the Village Mall. Professional vision care and eye health care. Name brand glasses and name brand sunglasses. Selection, selection, selection. And a guaranteed contact lens success program. Dr. Gavin McDale at Customized Vision Care.
Gunner fakes and then throws it out here. The play's got a man, Charlie Bell, first down, Newport, and more. Charlie still on his feet inside the 40, 35. Charlie running hard, still on his feet to the 32-yard line, first down, Newport.
Just one of those guys who
completes the number 22, Charlie Bell, for the Greyhound.
Every single play, and he gives
finally wrestled down by number 3,
every time they ask him.
Forward with number 4,
defensively offense for the Bears. Football on special
play was good enough for a Greyhound first down. Ball be spotted.
McCabe Cordell left, Biggers right, two tight ends. Call. That's inside. We'll get inside the 30 to about the 29-yard line.
25, that's Carl Turner.
Be second and around seven for Newport.
Tacklers were led by number 41, that's Jonathan Hicks.
Biggers out, Charlie Bell in. Colton out.
For the Bears. We'll say gain of about 3 yards.
Second and seven again for the Hounds. Ball at the 29 of Sylvan Hills. Stafford and Elston right. Bell and Cordell to the left. Gunner straight back. Incomplete, trying to hit a little screen to Elston. Incomplete, brings up third down and seven. Obviously four down territory inside the 30.
Played pretty well by Sylvan Hills that time.
And that'll bring up third and seven.
Third down and seven, and there's lots of things that you can do on third and seven. Obviously you're in four down territory, so you got a couple of chances here to get 7 yards. 5:30 to go, first quarter. We trail 7-0.
Three receivers left, one right. Carl behind Gunner. Delay to Carl. Can't hold his feet. Thought he was going to have a big play. Be inside near the 25-yard line. Fourth and short. Hounds obviously going for it. Fourth down and about two. Maybe three.
Number 56. That's
so close to a touchdown, David.
Well, there was a heavy rush coming on third and seven. Sylvan Hills
came about 4 yards on the play. That's going to bring up fourth and a short three.
Big play for the Hounds. Want to keep this drive alive after seeing how well Sylvan Hills can move it. Gunner keeps it. He'll have a first down and more. Gunner Bullard inside the 20. First down, Newport.
Senior quarterback, heady football player.
Stop was made by number 24.
Yeah, absolutely.
That play was good enough for a Greyhound first down.
One stops is the
Greyhound.
Yeah, inside the 20, obviously. Can't remember exactly, 16 maybe. I think more like 13.
Oh, it's a 13.
13, I believe, yes.
Yeah, because you said 87.
Gunner straight back, throws it deep. He's got McCabe. Touchdown, Newport. Bullard to Cordell. Touchdown, 7-6, Sylvan Hills.
You cannot run a route any better than that. You cannot run a route any better than that. You cannot execute any better than what the Newport Greyhounds just did on that play.
That was beautiful. Loosen that defense up a little bit, too.
Over the shoulder, and McCabe was there, and a beautiful catch, a great throw. Pretty good hookup from Gunner to McCabe.
It's tied up, McCabe. And Zach Alton will snap. Bullard to hold. Ball down, kicks up in the air, and it's good. Tied up at 7, 4:34 to go in the first quarter.
Good, folks. If you need any technology work done, you need your computer worked on this side, come to Radio Shack and ask me, hey, if you've got a computer bug, you just need to, you know, you need to have something fixed on your computer. This is the guy that you need to take your computer to. He's simply one of the best. He's at the Newport Technology Center, your Radio Shack dealer, and shop for all kinds of technological toys, as I call them, because they have them at Radio Shack. Newport Technology Center. Don't forget about the Soul Republic headphones. All different
back
styles.
Back deep for the Bears is
colors.
Number 22. That's Marlon Clemens.
Greyhound colors.
Oh, with number 5, license. Brandon Braceley.
Razorback license headphones also. At the Newport Technology Center, and I was reading a little bit ago, Randy, about got an email. Arkansas State University at Newport.
had a 22% increase in enrollment for the fall semester.
That's a lot.
That's a lot of folks. 22% increase. Obviously, the most kids we've ever had, most kids and adults, not just kids. Yeah.
Kicking off for the Greyhounds with the number eight, that's Jordan Neal.
Almost 2,500 kids, so congratulations to ASU Newport.
Julian Reed to kick off for Newport. The mid-range kick fielded at about the 20. It goes past him inside the 20. Let's get some coverage, guys. We've got guys coming. Great job by Biggers. Great return coverage there. Boy, Darren Biggers kept it from going outside, and then there's plenty of people to finish it off there. Good job, Hound kick team.
Yeah, Keith Washam was there first.
Tacklers were led
along
by
with
number
a couple
one,
other guys, and that's just good coverage by the Hounds.
Along with number 42, Deshaun Anderson for the Greyhounds.
Oh, white jersey.
Looks like the Bears will set up shop first.
4:24 remaining here in the first. We're tied at 7.
26-yard line.
Defense, how about a turnover here?
Let's go defense. And Trey Dawes, the outstanding senior quarterback. Motion man, lops him to the left, hands off inside. They'll have a nice gain past the 30 to about the 32-yard line. Gain of 6 on the play, 2nd and 4.
Conclusion of the broadcast. We always bring you the Coach Donnie Harrison show, and it's brought to you by Subway.
DeAndre Elton, along with number Walmart 39, Colton Willis for the Greyhounds. We'll take game about
Jeff
6. Bring up 2nd and 4.
Hand off inside again. Should be enough for a first down up to the 37-yard line.
Willis off tackle for the Bears.
1st and 10, Sylvan Hills.
I do like how the PA announcer says
stop was made
Bears.
By number 30, Keith Worsham for the Greyhounds. Play was good enough for a Bear first down.
1st and 10.
Spotted. 1st and 10 Bears at their own 37.
He's close to a PA guy.
He's all right.
Play by play guy, but not bad.
Doss keeps it this way. Pitches. Bobbled, but have a gain out of bounds to about the 42. Give him somewhere around 5 on the play, maybe 6. 2nd down, Sylvan Hills.
Yeah, Jordan Mabry with a tackle from behind. And good job of chasing the football from the backside. He may be on this.
He was forced out of bounds around the 43-yard line. We'll say gain of about 5 to 6 on that last
here.
Play. That's going to bring up 2nd and a long 5.
Clock stops with 3:37 to play in the first quarter.
2nd down, call it 5. Doss goes left, cuts inside. He'll have a nice game. Tackle made by Stafford, but be very close to the first down. Just short, I think. 3rd down and very short for Sylvan Hills.
Stop was made by number 49.
Stafford on the play.
Stafford for the Greyhounds.
Every week we bring
we'll
you the
about 4 yards on the play. It's going to bring up 3rd and about 1.
Third down, very, very short.
Thing you expect a long count.
What you normally would expect. Hand off inside, and they'll have a first down to midfield. Gain of 3, just inside Newport territory. 1st and 10, Sylvan Hills.
Sylvan Hills.
Stop was made by number 34, that's Denver Smith for the Greyhounds. Play was good enough for a Bear first down.
They like
ball been spotted. 1st and 10 Bears. And about the Greyhound, 49.
Dawes straight back, pumps, throws it deep. Good coverage by the Hounds, I think. And we'll have a flag on the play, and there will be interference.
That's intended for number 22, Marlon Clemens, falls incomplete. There is a rag on
like
the rotunda.
Coach Clinton Gore of the Osceola Seminole. No, excuse me. Coach Clinton Gore used to coach in Osceola. They could line up, they'd run 7 yards, 9 yards, 12 yards, and 9 yards, and 6 yards, and 9 yards, and 8 yards, and 6 yards.
Penalty was passed. Yep.
Newport fans wanted offensive interference, but that's rarely called. Be a 15-yard mark off. 1st and 10, Sylvan Hills be spotted just inside the 35 at the 34 of Newport. 1st and 10.
Yards from the original line of scrimmage, which will be good enough for a Bear first down. But the ball be spotted. 1st and 10 Bears. At about the Greyhound, 34-yard line.
Another 15-yard penalty for pass interference. I don't mind the pass interference penalties at all. It's just great effort on our part.
empty backfield.
Two receivers each way, blocking back. Watch Doss setting it up for him to run. Motion that way. He'll run, cut back this way, and he'll have a nice gain of about 12, first down, Sylvan Hills, inside the 25 of Sylvan, of Newport.
Stop was gained by number 15.
Putting the gain motion going one way.
That's DeAndre Elston for the Greyhound.
And they come back to the weak side.
Play was good enough for another Bear first down.
To play
but the ball be spotted. First and 10 Bears. What is said about the Greyhound? 23.
Two receivers each way. Empty backfield once again. Look for the motion. There he goes in a blocking back position. Doss will keep behind him. Hounds cannot make the play, and Doss will go score on an easy 22-yard touchdown for Sylvan Hills.
You got to have a little help outside the defensive end position. They're just getting the ball to the corner and outrunning us. And again, we knew these guys could put up points.
Yeah, we just got to match them. Maybe get a break somewhere. Doss will hold for the extra point attempt. Ball's down. Kicks up in there. It looks plenty good, and it is good. And with 2:06 to go in the first quarter, Sylvan Hills leads 14-7.
Find everybody that's the Remember Win program is now coming on Sunday nights at 5:30 and Tuesday nights at 5:30.
14
comes on at 7 o'clock.
Greyhound 7.
Remember Win, and this month's guest is Mr. Freeman Travis. Our good friend, our brother, Freeman Travis. And he and Bud sitting down a couple of weeks ago to do an interview, and it's a dandy.
Kicking off for the Bears will be number 26.
Or watch it on our webpage at www.cable15tv.com, which is also on YouTube, Facebook, and all the other social media networks. If you want to watch something, you've got an opportunity to. We'll put it out there. Kirk Rubber Company at Newport Air Base.
That's Darren Roddy.
1967.
Following number 22, Charlie Bell.
Family based business. Proud to be a part of the great Newport Greyhound tradition at Kirtner Lumber Company in NEDC, located in downtown Newport at the Newport Business and Resource Center. John Chadwell working for everyone in the area, for the area economy, striving for new businesses and jobs, as well as working with existing plants and industries to keep the folks here. Give them a visit at newportarcity.org. Proud past, bright future, NEDC and Newport.
Sylvan Hills to kick off for the third time. Short kick. Charlie will field it at the 20. Good coverage by Sylvan Hills. Charlie brought down at the 26-yard line. First and 10, Newport from the 26. 13 yards better than the last start.
Stop was made by number 40, that's Hunter Phillips for the Bears.
Almost 90 yards, their last possession.
Lost spot actually near the 28-yard line. Elston will split out wide left. Carl in the backfield. McCabe to the right. Two tight end look. Stafford on the left side. Willis on the right. Willis in motion this way. Hand off to Carl coming this way. Carl just runs over a guy and has a nice gain past the 35 near the 37-yard line. Nice gain by Carl.
Tackle for the Greyhound.
Be only about a yard short of a first down, I think.
Number four, James Waller for the Bears.
Second and one.
We'll say gain about 10 or 9 yards on the play. Bring up second and one.
Hounds with their third offensive possession. One punt and one touchdown on the two possessions.
Pass out here to McCabe. McCabe will have the first down up near the 39-yard line. Keep running that and set up the deep one to McCabe.
Stop was made by number 24, Tyler Davis for the Bears.
Get a couple yards.
That play was good enough for a Greyhound first down.
Now it's time for the long one.
10 Greyhounds. What about the long? 39-yard line.
Ben Collier in the game at the running back position. Off inside to Ben. Powell going forward to the 42-yard line. Gain of probably around three on the play, second and seven.
Ben Collier up the gut for Greyhound. Stop was made by number 56, Marquelin Jones for the Bears.
Make that gain of 4 seconds and six.
About 4 yards on the play. That's going to bring it up. Second in.
Jesse Simmons on the left side. Those five work hard during the game.
Collier. Cuts back. Ben's got almost had some room, but a good play by, I think, Mr. Dawes, the quarterback on defense.
For the Greyhounds, that open field stop was made by number 15, T.D. Dawes for the Bears.
8 seconds to play here in the quarter.
Third down, a long four for Sylvan Hills.
Now we'll say gain of a yard on the play. That's going to bring up third and about five.
Big possession play. Again, you don't want to give it back to this Sylvan Hills offense. We have not stopped them yet.
Hounds don't have to run a play. They have a 2 second advantage if they want to talk about it before the quarter. After the quarter ends.
We're going to run it. Gunner straight back. Flushed out. Looking, buying time. Throws it. Great catch by Stafford had it and just couldn't hold on to it. Brings up fourth down.
Boyer's pass intended for number 49.
Well, Gunner scrambled like he does so well. Found an open receiver streaking.
And that'll bring up fourth and about five. And that is the end of the first quarter of play. With your score, the Sylvan Hills Bears 14 and the Newport Greyhounds 7.
That's the end of the first quarter. Your score, Sylvan Hills 14, Newport 7. It'll be time for Charlie Bell to punt when we start the second quarter.
And businesses that have made these renovations possible here at Bill Blackford Field. Our field sponsors, Rodney Buick GMC of Sherwood,
caring for our community.
And Arkansas Bank and Trust.
What a job those
guys
do. Our
track sponsor, Crane Automotive. Our legacy sponsor, Telco Credit Union,
CHI St.
Vincent, and State Representative Jim Nichols.
Having fun
our Super Banner sponsors, McDonald's, Sherwood A&T Commission, Gregory Polaris, Harrison Renshaw Physical Therapy, and the Sylvan Hills High School Athletic Booster Club.
He is. I have a hard time hearing you sometimes.
Sonic, Malcolm Avenue, Newport,
Sherwood Development,
going on at Sonic.
And the Sylvan Hills High School Band Booster Club.
Oh, I can't even concentrate.
It's really difficult.
Do a little business with Sonic. Josh and all the crew. 2 to 4 in the afternoon. Drinks half price.
Fourth and five. Newport Hounds do not line up to punt. We'll see what we do here. Line up to go for it. It is fourth and five. Newport have to get very near midfield, just inside midfield.
They quickly call it.
Sylvan Hill see that we're going for it. They're going to talk about it.
Sylvan Hill.
They had a guy deep. So they had 10 guys to play defense. So
the
Hounds did put something there.
Continuing on, our benefactor sponsors,
one person
State
advantage.
Representative Jane English,
Sonic Drive in Mountain Avenue, Newport, City of Newport,
Tier Time Revolution, the Miller Family Businesses of NIPC and Safety.com.
Gracious, I'm getting old.
Watson's
offering
Cleaning
free
Service.
Paper Shredding Service.
Nate Person and Apartment Painters of Little Rock.
Call ahead at 217-0070.
And James Bowen and Bowen Roofing Company.
Clothing, electronics,
once
aluminum,
again, a great
plastic,
big
white
thank
paper,
you to these folks
paper,
and
cardboard,
for their
you name it, they do it. It's
Sylvan Hills Athletics.
And Jackson's Funeral Home. Our family serving your family. A life well lived is worth remembering. Because we all need to be remembered, care and comfort in your family's time of need, the Jackson's Funeral Home.
Needless to say, huge play for the Hound offense. Fourth down and right at five. Have to get just inside midfield. Ben Collier, be short of a first down. Hound's about 3 yards short. Ball turns over on downs to Sylvan Hills.
The Greyhounds.
Hounds thought they could get five. They're
stop
going to get about three.
Number 13, Tyler
so
Reed,
the defense back
along with number 79, that's Hayden the Hawk Hawkins. Looks like the ball will be short
and
of a Greyhound first
short
down. Ball will go over on downs to the Bears.
That's what Coach Harrison's
like the
thinking
Bears
there.
Set up shop first and
these
10.
These guys are real good offense.
Just inside
we need to
the Greyhound, 47
line.
Absolutely. You got to try to match them score for score. And that's two times we have not taken it to the house. First and 10, Sylvan Hills at the Newport 47. Hand off outside, 22, and he'll gain to about the 42-yard line. Gain of five on the play, closer, maybe close to six. Second down and four.
By number three, McCabe Cordell for the Greyhound.
On the outside, on both sides.
We'll say gain of almost 6 yards on the play. That's going to bring up second and a long four.
About the 41, second and four. And off to the left side, and again he gets outside and gets a big gain, and you run out of bounds near the 20-yard line of Newport, and just Sylvan Hill's getting it in chunks, David.
Well, and again, they're taking the ball to the corner.
He was forced out of bounds by number 10, Ben Collier.
Along with
number 30, he forced them for the Greyhound.
11:41
to play. That play was good enough for a fair first down.
And Sylvan Hill's
in a
hurry once again.
First and 10 Bears. We're going to say it about the Greyhound. 21.
Sylvan Hill's going to call it their second timeout.
And we've got a timeout. I believe that's against the Greyhound.
It's actually called against Newport. Newport timeout there first of the first half. And with 11:41 to go here in the second quarter, Hounds trail 14-7.
Your financial guidance should be about trust and not about sales. Modern Woodman agents Brenda Benish and Matt Ward offer free financial help. You can call Brenda at 523-2977. Modern Woodman, Brenda Benish. Planning for life with Modern Woodman of America.
Again,
Subway,
that's Janet Roy.
Planters,
please see the folks at the front ticket gate. They have your 1984 class reunion
Subway
banner available right now.
Planters. Subway in the new Walmart Supercenter. Norman Baker Pharmacy, Mary Davis and crew at 1117 McLean Street, 523-9472. With a convenient drive-through window, you can call your order in. Call your order in on your medicine. That's what I do. I call it in. Drive-through. Hey, folks, here I am. Is it ready? Yes, it is. Pick it up. Norman Baker Pharmacy, 1117 McLean Street.
Been avoiding those offsetting pills this week?
That's right.
All right, good.
Yeah. I just take everything.
First and 10, Sylvan Hills.
Play resumes. The Bears will have the ball. First and 10.
Ball just outside the 20.
Down, 21-yard line.
Throws it deep. Incomplete. Bring up second down and 10.
Dawson's pass intended for number 7, Nate Thomas.
11:35 to go here in the second quarter. Hounds trail 14-7. Sylvan Hills on the move again. And they've had the ball twice and have two touchdowns. Hounds have had it three times and only one. You've got to match them.
Hounds have Big Jesse in there defensively now. Right beside Hayden. A little extra beef and bulk up front for the Hounds.
Doss hands off to the right side and spread out well by the Hounds. Fairly short gain on the play, more than I thought he was going to get, but he'll have it to about the 17-yard line. Brings up third down and around six for Sylvan Hills.
I think there was Colton Willis out there who did a great job that time of preventing the guy from going around the end.
Yeah.
And you've got to have some type of penetration.
We've got to have it, yeah.
We'll say gain of about 5 yards on the play. That's going to bring up third and about five.
Third down, Sylvan Hills. Four down territory inside the 20. Motion to the left. And off inside, and they'll have a first down, I think, near the 11-yard line.
32.
Very close to a first down. Not seeing an indication from the official, but yeah, it's first down, Sylvan Hills.
That was made by number 30, Keith Worsham.
First and effectively goal near the 11, I think. They are going to bring the change in for measurement. They'd already put a one on the down marker.
And it looks like we have an official's timeout for a measurement.
Down near the 10, but I don't think it's at the 10.
No, it's short. Said, yeah, short of the 10, but it may be a first down.
Absolutely.
They had to get to the 11, I think.
We'll see. We'll carry the change out there and remind everybody about the services offered at Harris Hospital, including cardiac care, diagnostic imaging, emergency department, home health services, laboratory services, orthopedic services, lots of other services too. All
like the measurement's going to leave the Bears just a hair short.
Harris Hospital, 1200 Main Street, more than care.
Inches for the Bears.
Visit them on the website at harrishospital.com. Get the booster luncheon each and every Monday. Here's
about the Greyhound 12-yard line.
We just talked about the previous football game.
Fourth and inches. Hound fans on their feet. Have to have some big penetration from the Newport interior line. Ball straight ahead, and he'll have a first down and more inside the 10. First down, Sylvan Hills. First and goal.
TD Dodds on the quarterback there. Sneak for the Bears.
300 plus at center guard and guard. Pretty tough to match up with that physically. The first down and goal here for Sylvan Hills.
Looks like he got about 3 yards on that play, which will be good enough for the Bear first down. Hope he spotted first and goal Bears. And about the Greyhound, 8 yard line.
First and goal at the 8. 32. Good play by the Hound. There's the Hound defense. Stafford and others, and that's what I was expecting tonight. Loss on the play. Back outside the 10, second and goal. They're giving great forward progress, actually, inside the 10. I didn't see that, but a loss of about one.
They got lost about a yard on the play. Opening up second and goal from the 9.
Second and goal, ball just inside the 10. On defense, another big play.
Some confusion in the offensive line, and Sylvan Hills wants a timeout.
Yeah, Doss was pointing, and
Sylvan Hills.
Something was wrong there, and they'll call their second timeout of the first half. We have 10-11 to go here in the second quarter. Hounds trail 14-7.
Hey, you like to once again remind all
Yeah, of course, Super Nacho Fajita Chicken on Wednesday.
September the 23rd from 4 to close.
Of course, yeah.
It's most night in North Little Rock.
Sometimes, yeah. Not every time.
20% of all the sales that night. Sylvan Hills Athletic Department. So if you're out and about and or just needing a bite to eat, welcome to Moe's.
What about their sweet tea?
Again, I love their tea. I'm an unsweet tea.
That's sweet.
Fake sugar in it. All the teas are simply outstanding.
Also, I'd like to send out a big thank you to Moe's for supplying the food tonight. For the folks in
all
the press
nachos,
box,
yeah.
And all the
everything
game workers.
Never had a bad meal in there.
It's all good.
All in, and you can drive through and pick it up at the window, 523-2369. Great food, excellent service, and loving the Hounds at El Puente.
Yeah, again, the service is one of the great things. You feel like everybody's your friend
Absolutely.
There.
Absolutely,
yeah.
You sure do. It's a homely type, homey type atmosphere. Well, homely, homey.
Homey. Second and goal, just inside the 10. Come on, Hound defense.
We need to stop.
Motion. Doss keeps it, and he'll score easy. Trey Doss, 9-yard touchdown run, and that's why he is highest touted. Sylvan Hills leads 20-7.
Well, the Hounds elected to go for it on 4th and 5, and gave Sylvan Hills a short field. And we'll go up 2 scores here, but no need to panic. You just got to put points on the board. You got to score, certainly now, every time you get your hands on the football.
Ball down. Kick looks good. It is good. And with 10:07 to go in the second quarter, Hounds trail 21-7.
It's good. And with
what the Hounds have got to do now, they have to answer down here. Stay in this football game. 10:07 to play in the first half.
And the Newport Greyhounds, 7.
What a crowd on hand. Right, boy, Sylvan Hills stands across the way, just packed. And there's Dan giving you shot of that. It's nice to get to see the monitor. You know, we don't get to see the monitor.
No, never do.
Look at that crowd. Looks like a college crowd. And they are very, very vocal.
Big night for them again. I guess the dedication of the new field here, the new turf for them, it looks great and just good for those guys. Ours looks pretty good too.
Greenway of Newport, your John Deere dealer. And Ben Black does his custom lawn care. Everything he's got, steel products from Greenway.
Kicking off for the Bears will be number 26, Christian Falcon. Back deep for the Greyhounds is number 2, Darren Ruddy.
And all came from Greenway of Newport, your local John Deere dealer, but your steel dealer also. Never too early to shop for Christmas toys, boots, and John Deere.
Along with number 22, Charlie Bell.
Greenway Boots Company, 523-2781.
Jordan Neal, Julian Reed, Deshaun Anderson, Zach Alton, McCabe Cordell, DeAndre Elston, Warsham Bell. Roddy short kick. He caught over there near the sideline by Elston. Hounds will have good field position, probably around the 34-yard line. First and 10, Newport from their own 34.
Pooch kick was fielded by number 15, DeAndre Elston, for the Greyhounds.
Murphy
went out of bounds around the 34-yard line.
That offensive line.
The Greyhounds will set up shop first and 10.
Holton Willis will be one of the receivers or tight ends. McCabe Cordell. Was Carl Turner and Gunner Bullard. DeAndre will split wide right.
First and 10 from the 34. Hounds need to answer. And up inside, Carl. Carl still on his feet, running past the 42 near the 43-yard line. Gain of about nine, second and one.
25, that's Carl Turner off tackle for the Greyhound.
Gets hit.
Probably brought down by number three, D'Angelo Bell for the Bears. Once they gain him almost 9 yards on the play, that'll bring up second and one.
Bell and Willis and Turner all out. Collier back in. Mabry in.
Some type of a power set here.
I formation, Roddy at fullback, Collier at tailback. Hounds need two. Hand off to Collier. He'll have a first down and more. Puts that head down like Carl does and gets up to about the 47, 48-yard line. First down, Newport.
Greyhounds. Long field tackles made by number six.
Clock stops.
Jones.
9-12 to play in the half. First half action.
Looks like that play was good enough for a Greyhound first down.
Hounds need an answer.
Ball be spotted. First and 10, Greyhounds. And about their own 48-yard line.
And Hounds have not matched Sylvan Hills, but still in this football game. Especially if we can go score here, we'll stay in the I formation. And Roddy and Collier behind Gunner under center. Toss sweep to the left. Collier, 45. Ben still on his feet. Ben near the 46-yard line, a gain of about 7 or 8, depending on the spot. Good first down gain for Newport.
Well, there's nothing like having speed.
Ball number 10, Ben Collier on his feet for the Greyhounds. Stop was made by number 24, Tyler Davis.
Too, but Ben Collier's a guy that
well, with number 5, Brandon Bracelet.
We'll give
for
him
the Bears.
6 on the play. Second and 4, Turner back in the game, along with Bell and Willis.
It's a game of about 7 on the play. It's going to bring
Mabry out along with Collier and Roddy. Hounds have to get to the 42. Carl cuts back, still running hard. Carl, he stopped about a yard short of the first down. He shot between the 43 and 44. He has to get up to around the 42. Be third down about a yard and a half. We have 8 minutes to go in the second quarter. Hounds trail 21-7, but are moving.
Number 56, Marquelin Jones for the Bears.
Let's go Hounds!
They gained a yard on the play. It's going to bring up third and about two.
Let's go Hounds!
Four down territory without a doubt. Gunner looks to the sideline for the play. Carl, first down and more. Carl Turner. Near the 36-yard line, first down, Newport.
Carl Turner, Greyhound.
Once you get past the 50, you start going downhill.
Stop with the new run by number 41, Jonathan Hicks. Along with number 56, Marquelin Jones for the Bears.
The left side of that offensive line over there, great job, Murphy and Simmons.
Ball be spotted, first and 10, Greyhound.
Mabry, Mabry back in the game.
Come on, Hounds.
Roddy at fullback, Carl the tailback. Gunner straight back, throws it across the middle, to the outside, and great coverage by Sylvan Hills. Trying to go deep, and just great coverage.
Yeah, DeAndre had cornerback coverage, man-to-man.
Pass intended for number 15, DeAndre Elston, was broken up by number 5, Brandon Bracelet for the Bears. Ball's incomplete. That'll bring up second and
some of the offensive linemen after saying something over to coach like, let's run this so-and-so play over to my side because I'm whipping my guy. Well, big Jesse saying, bring it over here, guys. Second down and 10 for the Hounds. 7:18 to play in the half. 21-7, we trail.
Turner and Mabry out. Two receivers each way. Kyron split out just a little bit. Little screen to McCabe. He'll have it to right at the 31-yard line. Gain of 5. It'll be third and 5 for Newport.
Greyhounds.
Good possession pass there.
Stop was made by number 5, Brandon Bracelet for the Bears.
Line service taking care of farmers for decades.
We'll say gain of
width and with the best.
About 5 yards on the play
service.
To bring up third and about 5.
Third and 5, ball near the 30-yard line, I formation. Roddy and Collier in the eye. Toss right and played well. A number 9 and a big loss on the play will bring up fourth down and about 12 for Newport.
In the backfield,
and the Hounds will have to
nine,
possibly punt. I don't think so from that field position. Charlie and Carl back in the game.
Loss of about 6 yards on the play. That's going to bring up fourth and 11.
Fourth down and 11. Hounds have to get very near the... Hunter straight back. Throws it, and he's got a man. Elston, first down, Newport. Great pass, great catch. Bullard to Elston.
And you've got it fourth and 11. You've got
that's
a guy
completion number 15, DeAndre Elston for the Greyhound.
Great confidence in your quarterback to put it on the money. A tad high. Elston went high.
Down around the, we're going to say the 22-yard line.
Hound's going fast.
Greyhound first down.
Carl. Carl running hard inside the 20 near the 18-yard line. Second down.
Ball carrier was number 25.
So a gain of about three, I think. Second down and seven, maybe six.
We'll see.
Mabry out.
Three on that last play. It'll bring up second and seven.
Wills Nelson right. Charlie goes out to the left. Gunner straight back, pumps. Throws it for Elston. Out of his reach. Out of bounds. Brings up third down and seven for Newport.
I like to call.
DeAndre Elston falls
incomplete.
And that'll bring up third down.
Trying to run past the quarterback. He's played real well defensively by the corner. Third down and seven. Farmer's Tire Mart, 1501 Malcolm Avenue. Tires for your car, truck, trailers, ATV, lawnmowers. Service on your automobile at Farmer's Tire Mart.
Third down and seven for Newport. Two receivers each way. Charlie in motion to the left. Little wrap around to Carl. Had some room, but it closed quickly. It'll be inside the 15 to the 14. Fourth down and three for Newport. Obviously going for it here.
Tripped up by number 41, Jonathan Hicks for the Bears.
Sylvan Hill's bringing in the beef.
We'll see, gain him about 5 yards on the play. That's going to bring up fourth and about.
Short two. A short two. Converted on a fourth and 11 a while ago.
Huge possession down, obviously. 4:45 to go here in the first quarter. First half, excuse me. And Hound's going to call a timeout and talk about this.
Well, I think Donnie realizes the importance of this.
And we've got a timeout.
Hound's going to be able to afford not to score on this possession and get the football back to first with 4 minutes to go. But the ball game not remains in the balance on this particular possession, but it's going to be real, real tough if the Hounds don't score to give them the football back, because we have shown no signs of being able to slow these guys, and we thought that might be the case. Nothing against our defense at all. We're playing hard.
They're good.
Very, very good offensively.
Yeah, they're good.
Kell Motors, lead sponsor for Remember When, Chevrolet, GMC, and Buick dealer, 523-2792. You can visit their whole inventory on georgekellmotors.com. Price those vehicles. You can send in a credit app and get the information and give them a call at 2792. Lots of information on the website, all their inventory at George Kell Motor Company in St. Michael's Place, 1311 North Pecan Street, 523-9514. Skilled nursing home facility. Whether it's short-term or long-term care, give St. Michael's Place a call at 523-9514.
Here it is, fourth and two. Darren Moore in from the sideline. Three receivers left. And Hound's going nowhere. A read, and we lose on the play back to the 15. Sylvan Hills holds once again. First and 10, them.
Well, you hope that you can get those 2 yards.
Stop was made by number 24,
Tyler
Davis.
Got to make a stop.
Well, with number 56, Mark Quaylen Jones for the Bears.
Stop these guys.
Looks like he will stop short of the first down. Ball will go over on downs to the Bears. Looks like the Bears will set up shop first and 10, just outside their own 15-yard line.
Can the Hounds get a stop?
Motion. Dolls. And Elston hopefully will stop him. And boy, a big gain past midfield. That's Mr. Dolls as advertised.
TD Dolls on the quarterback keeper for the Bears.
Reads that option very, very well.
Stop was made by number 15, DeAndre Elston.
Reminded me of Kendall Council.
Big gainer for the Bears, shooting up for a first down. Ball be spotted. First and 10 Bears.
7,000.
How about the Greyhound? 49.
First and 10 inside the 50 of Newport. Running back, nice little cut back, and he'll be up to the 44-yard line. Like Stafford on the bottom of that pile.
Number 32, Fred Williams for the Bears.
4:07.
Stop was made by number 30, Keith Borsham for the Greyhounds. We'll say gain of four in the play. Bring up second and six.
Off inside. Good job by the Hound defense. Boy, Sylvan Hill's going very fast. Hounds really weren't even lined up that time before they snapped it.
Number 32, Fred Williams up the gut for the Bears. Stop was made by number 49.
Well, at the 41-yard line.
42.
Third and
Anderson for the Greyhounds.
About two. Motion. There's a flag, and that'll be called back. A little motion penalty against Sylvan Hills. I guess that's their first penalty of the first half.
There is a towel on the terra firma.
For the third and long one. It's going to be third and a long six. Short seven. 3:29. Clock stops until they get it marked off.
Penalty was a dead ball offside against the Greyhound.
It's against Newport.
Cost them an Abe Lincoln. And be good enough for a Bear first down. Ball be spotted. First and 10 Bears. How about the Greyhound? 36.
Might have jumped off sides again.
Yeah, I thought we did.
I know we moved.
Yeah, most off sides against Newport.
That was another flag. That penalty again was off sides against the Greyhounds. That'll cost
moves it up to the 30-yard line. First and five.
So the ball spotted right around the Greyhound 30-yard line.
Ball straight back, we'll throw it deep, has a man open. And they'll call interference against Newport.
I thought their guy
was intended for number two, Cameron Hughes. There is a flag on the play. Penalty was pass interference against the Greyhounds.
Things aren't going well for the Hounds right now, but you've got to keep battling.
That's all you can do. We're not the first team they've done this to. Scored in the 40s both of the first two games against 5A competition.
Penalty stepped off 15 yards from the original line of scrimmage, which will be good enough for a fair first down. Let the ball be spotted. First and 10 Bears. How about the Greyhound? 15-yard line.
Off inside to 32, and he will be very near the goal line up to about the 2-yard line. First and goal, Sylvan Hills. 2:55 to go in the first half. They lead 21-7 and knocking at the door.
Yeah, the Hounds just haven't had an answer defensively.
Second stop was made by number 39,
so big up front
for the Greyhounds. Play was good enough for a fair first down. Let like the ball be spotted. First and goal, Bears. We're going to save the Greyhounds. Three.
Up inside, and that'll be a Sylvan Hills touchdown, I think. Yep. 2:37 to go in the first half. They score on a 2-yard run and lead 27-7.
Touchdown, Bears!
Well, not a lot you can say other than we thought coming in that these guys were going to put points on the board, and we hope we could match those guys score for score. The Hounds with one touchdown on the night. We got close on another one. Just couldn't convert on a fourth and two. Extra point attempt coming.
Ball's down, kicks up in the air, and it looks good. It is good. And with 2:34 to go in the second quarter, Sylvan Hills Bears lead your Newport Greyhounds 28-7.
Extra point attempt by number 26, Christian Bolton.
It comes a learning process now. You learn a little bit about yourself. You learn a little bit about how good you really want to be and how much you really want to prepare. You got 2.5 minutes right here.
And the Newport Greyhounds.
28-7, and we haven't been able to stop them. You don't think we're going to outscore them. by three touchdowns in the second half. You have to score in this last 2-4,
right,
I think, to have any chance at all. And we're talking about learning. You're just trying to make some adjustments at halftime and see what you can do to come out to play better in the second half than what you played in the first half. I don't think we've played just horribly.
No, not. They're just good offensively. Yeah. That's all you can say. And as I said earlier, we are not the first team that they've been piling the points up on. They've scored 41 and 48 the first 2 weeks against at least 5A competition.
Back deep for the Greyhounds is number 2, Aaron Roddy, along with number 22, Charlie Bell.
I try not to make that noise. That noise you hear is me moving my microphone up and hitting my glasses.
Done that before.
I will scold myself tomorrow morning when I listen to it on TV. Don't do that anymore, David.
Long kick this time. Charlie. 15, 20. Charlie Bell running hard. Boy, Charlie caught that at full speed, and he was not going to be slowed.
A couple of good blocks.
Kick off with tremendous by number 22,
that's what you
got to
have. You
got to
keep fighting.
Yep.
You got to keep fighting right here. 2:29 to play.
Was made by number 30, Cameron Sharp for the Bears.
Get a score.
The return for the Greyhounds looks like they'll set up shop first and 10 at their own 44.
Gives you hope, yeah. First and 10 from the 44.
Come on, Hound.
Gunner. Straight back, pump fake. In trouble. Tries to get out of there, and against this defense, it's a little harder to get out of there. And he'll be stopped for a loss of 4 back to the 40.
More of a coverage sack than anything else. Newport.
Sack was made by number 59, John Peebles.
Not a huge loss, a loss of about 3. 2:07 remaining in the half.
Along with number 56, that's Marquelin Jones. We'll say loss of about 3 on the play. Bring up 2nd and 13.
Gunner rolls to the right. In trouble again. Throws it for DeAndre. DeAndre's got it. Still on his feet. We'll see where he stepped out at. They'll mark it at the 48 and a half yard line. First down, Newport.
Forward pass is complete to number 15 at DeAndre Elston. While he forced out of bounds by number 3, D'Angelo Bell for the Bears.
Oh, just short. Yeah, I forgot about the loss on the previous on first down. Third down and
we'll say gain of about
call it 3. They have to get to the 46 yard line.
About 3.
Gunner scrambling again. Found a man open. DeAndre with a big catch.
Gunner and Carl in the backfield. Out here to DeAndre. We'll go forward, DeAndre. Good power, and he'll have a first down with effort there.
Yeah, he was met right at the first down marker. And DeAndre won that
number
battle.
Number 15, that's DeAndre Elston. Wrestled down by number 6, Romello Jones.
Yeah, clock continues to move, and it's not
low with number 41, Jonathan Hicks. That play was good enough for a first down for Greyhound. Ball will be spotted. First and 10, Greyhounds at the Bear, 44.
And hauling about the clock.
Ran the clock during the whole stoppage time. Gunner fakes.
Got a man wide.
Got a man open. Throws it for Biggers and great coverage by Sylvan Hills. There'll be no flag.
He was open early and then the safety from the far side came. Gunner didn't seem quick enough to be able to scramble.
That's intended for number 11, Darren Biggers. The ball is incomplete and that'll bring up 2nd and 10.
Second and 10, Newport. 1:01 to go in the first half. Hounds wanting to answer here and get within 2 possessions. Gunner straight back. Flushed out to the left. Throws it. Complete. No, incomplete. Trying to get Charlie over there. We're just great pursuit by that Sylvan Hills defense.
Yeah, Gunner had to scramble once again. I've seen that all year long.
Charlie Bell because out of nothing. And that's going to bring up 3rd and 10.
3rd down and 10 for the Hounds. Clock stops, 54 seconds remaining. Everybody's getting excited. Billy Keaty in the stands had noticed it early. The clock continued to move after the first down. supposed to stop on every first down, and it didn't stop.
Third and 10. Gunner's in deep trouble. He fumbles the football, and luckily we get on it. And Hounds will have to punt it. Sylvan Hills probably call a timeout here, and they will. Their third and final timeout.
There was a fumble on the play. The ball was recovered by number 54, that's Sam Bowen for the Greyhounds.
Sylvan Hills does want a timeout. They get one with 38 seconds. 28-7.
And we've got a timeout, Sylvan Hills. That is the last timeout of the first half.
I remind everybody the Graham Boosters include John Miner Jr., and he has a great farm package insurance, one of the largest farm packages available. Includes homeowners, farm machinery, farm building, irrigation, automobiles. It's a general liability umbrella policy.
That last play resulted in a loss of 13 for the Greyhounds, so
also
that's going to bring up fourth and about 23.
Covers everything in farming operation. John Miner Jr., give John Miner Sr. a call at 523-8900. Glass Plus, Highway 367 North, car and truck windshield, picture framing, general or specific framing, 523-3505. Greyhound Boosters.
Zach Alton to snap. Charlie to punt. 45 seconds.
I was thinking they had the football. I don't know why I was thinking that.
Snap rugby style punt by Charlie, and it'll be a low line drive and go out of bounds right around the 34, I think.
That's imperative, Wisconsin.
Yeah, absolutely. They'll mark it right at the 34. The first and 10, Sylvan Hills. 41 seconds to go here in the half. Again, they have no timeouts, and they have 66 yards to go.
For the Bears will take over first and 10.
That comes for announcers sometimes, too.
Bowen, Schultz, Roddy, Mabry, the defensive line.
Are they going to run it, or are they going to throw it deep right here? They're throwing it right.
I think that they wouldn't call a timeout if they weren't going for it all the way here. Of course, 15's dangerous keeping it, too. And do we have the first penalty of the first half against the Bears?
There is polyester on the Ponderosa. Kelly was a false start against the Bears.
Five-yard penalty against Sylvan Hills.
First and 15.
40 seconds remaining in the half. 28-7, we trail. Dan, we'll get out of here quickly and get me the time, please, sir.
Dahl straight back. There comes the heat. Sam Bowen chasing him. Throws it. Complete near the sideline. Great job by Dawes.
Dawes' pass again, is complete to number seven, Nathan Thomas for the Bears.
The Greyhounds and found an open receiver into Newport territory. 31 seconds to go. They're out of timeout.
You got to stop them inbound short of first down, although they do not stop the clock apparently for first down, so maybe that'll be all right.
Greyhounds, that play was good enough for a fair first down. All be spotted. First and 10 Bears at the Greyhound, 47.
Two receivers left, two right. Motion this way. Doss again straight back. Throws it across the middle. It picked off by Carlton. No, DeAndre Elston with the interception. Great job, DeAndre.
That's big right there.
Intercepted by number 15, DeAndre Elston.
Keep them getting near the end zone and keeping them out of the end zone.
Set up shop and handle at about their own 37-yard line.
Offensive plan. Let's see how they want to handle this right here. Rambo Agron Lending, a leader in crop lending, Shane Hutchinson. Our own Shane Hutchinson, who handles our stats each and every Friday night. 217-2171, Rabo Agri Lending. That's a stat man right there, isn't he?
There he is. He's kind of relaxed tonight.
He does, doesn't he?
First and 10 from the 37. 26 seconds to go in the half. Hounds with a couple of timeouts. I think we're at one left. Gunner flushed out, has all kinds of time, but great coverage. The incomplete brings up second down and 10. 18 seconds to go in the half. Just great coverage by Sylvan Hills. Their secondary is outstanding.
Bring up second and 10. Mark Manning, Shelter Insurance, 523-6514. Most insurance needs. Visit with Mark Manning, former Newport Greyhound.
Second and 10, Newport. 18 seconds to go in the first half. It's out to Charlie Bell and incomplete. That'll bring up third and 10.
Swing pass intended for number 22, Charlie Bell, falls incomplete. And that'll bring up third and 10.
Third down and 10 for the Hounds. 14 seconds left, trailing 28-7.
See if Hounds may try to break Carl or something different here. Two straight incompletes. Gunner straight back. Scrambles. In trouble, be downed at the 37-yard line, and the clock will go ahead and run out, I think. Sylvan Hills has no timeouts left to stop it. And that's the end of the first half with your score. Sylvan Hills 28, Newport 7.
Second half action
by number 13, Tyler Reed for the Bears.
28-7 in favor of Sylvan Hills. We've had a halftime that you didn't get to see. With the halftime stats, my tag team partner, Randy Corpeche.
Thanks, David. Again, once again, our thanks to Shane Hutchinson for compiling these throughout the game. First down, Sylvan Hills 14, Newport 8 rushing. Of course, total domination by Sylvan Hills, 225 to Newport 76. Passing, of course, Newport leads through the air, 8 out of 18 for 114 yards. Sylvan Hills, 1 out of 2 for 24 yards. Total offense, Sylvan Hills 249, Newport 190. Penalties, Newport 6 for 65. Sylvan Hills only the 1 for 5. Newport no turnovers. That's been good. Sylvan Hills the one interception by DeAndre Elston. Rushing, Carl Turner leads the way with 11 carries for 62 yards. Receiving, DeAndre Elston has 4 catches for 68 yards.
Randy, you see when you have statistics like that that are pretty one-sided, as a coach, I mean, one of those guys talk about at halftime. What do you think they talk about?
I just think you got to start again. You know, I don't think you panic. You know, you just come out and play your game. You start a new game in the second half. I don't think, you know, you have to do anything. I don't think you'll do anything a whole lot different than what you planned for throughout the week.
Yeah, just keep going back to the game plan and try to win the second half.
Yeah.
To win the second half and get some positive going into next week. It doesn't get much easier.
No.
On the road again at a very hostile environment at Helena West, I don't know. The Cougars will be tough.
Yeah, I'm sure they'll be tough. You know, we've never played there before, obviously. They've always been in a higher classification, but we're excited to get conference started. You know, that next season, we always talk about, you know, the non-conference season and then the conference season. So that's what it's all about. You know, we want to get better in the second half. You know, it's still possible we can come back and win it. Yeah, but let's just play well and get our game back and be ready for next week.
Sylvan Hills will get the football to start the second half. Brought to you by Iberia Bank, Billy Keating. Will and Jake and the boys and coach, of course, Iberia Bank at Lindley Drive and all your banking business, 523-3611, Billy Keaty at Iberia Bank. Churchman Building Center, Ace Hardware. You've got major remodeling or
start
minor
the
repairs.
Half, the Bears will be receiving
stuff for all
and
your projects and building
the
needs.
East goal.
Located at 1500 Highway 367 North in Newport, Churchman Building Center. Larry Lou Allen representing three generations of Greyhound football players, 407 Walnut Street, 523-6764, business accounting services, tax prep and planning, and management consulting, Larry Lou Allen and company in downtown Newport. Sam's Diner, folks, if you want a plate lunch, can I recommend the Tuesday meatloaf or the Friday chicken and dressing? All the
kicking off for the Greyhounds will be number 8.
Second Street, Newport. You got a great plate lunch for
number 5, Brandon Priestley. Oh, number 22, Marlon Clemens.
And it is absolutely excellent at Sam's Diner.
Julian Reed will kick off for Newport to start the second half. Low kick, fielded at the 33 by a big, tall guy. He's coming this way, but number 11, Darren Biggers. With the tackle, there's a flag on the play, face mask. Hounds with their seventh penalty of the game, if that's the way it goes, and we think it will.
For the Greyhound, there is a Sam Wow on the Serengeti.
Against the Greyhound.
Still no indication from the referee, but we know it's what it's got to be. Face mask. 5 yards against Newport. That was discussion whether it was 5 or 15. They'll move it up to the 42-yard line. We'll be first and 10, Sylvan Hills.
5-yard face mask penalty. That'll be tacked on to the end of the run.
And about 24 minutes to set up half. You notice when the second half.
That should be our goal. Let's get a stop defensively. We've got one tonight with the DeAndre Elston interception. Motion. Doss gives to him around the right side, and boy, just great blocking, and he's got a big gain up to about the 40-yard line. Gain of 18 on the play. First and 10, Sylvan Hills.
Sylvan Hills going back to the
stop
bread and butter.
Stop by number 30, Keith Borsham for the Greyhound. Big hanger for the Bears. Good enough for a first down. Ball be spotted. First and 10, Bears.
There's ability, or I should say their ability to get to the
42-yard line.
It's a good offensive football team.
Gain of 16, actually, on the play. First and 10 from the Newport 42. Motion. A little sweep again, and again he gets outside. A great move to get outside, and he may go score. He's inside the 15 to about the 11. First and 10, Sylvan Hills, and this is very dominant offensive performance.
Yeah, they're just running it well. DeAndre Elston for the Greyhounds. Another big gainer for the Bears. Good enough for a first down. Looks like the ball will be spotted.
How we slow these guys down when they try to pass it.
Yeah.
At about the Greyhound, 12-yard line.
First and 10 from the 12.
What about running here?
Doss keeps it inside. Played pretty well by the Hounds. He'll get inside the 10 barely. Gain of 2 on the play. Second and 8. Warsham around the play.
Well, they have the ability to run
ball
the ball inside.
15,
they have the ability
TD
to
fake
inside
keeper and quarterback
the keep. They have the ability to fake.
Stop was made by number 49.
On a speed sweep.
Iran Stanford.
Into speed at the skill position.
For the Greyhound. Great gain about 3 on the play. Bring up second and 7.
Second and 7. And off inside, and boy, it's easy. 32 again.
Number 32, Fred Williams up the gut. Touchdown!
For the Bears to score.
That's it.
Up 34-7. No answers defensively for the Hounds tonight.
No, been none. As we said, they scored 41 and 48 the first 2 weeks. They've been doing this all year and will probably do it most of the year. Ball down, kicks up in there. It's good, and with the 10:54 to go in the third quarter. Sylvan Hills leads 35-7.
Greyhound boosters include Mark and Beverly
and
McCoy.
And with 10:54 left in the third, you're going out. That's Sylvan Hills Bears. 35.
Sandy.
And the Newport Greyhound. 7.
John Sheridan Chadwell. Gifts for special occasions. Whether it be wedding, birthdays, holidays, give them a call at 523-5872. And the battery guys at BNT Battery, Neil and Keith. 2400 Highway 367 North, 523-2758. If you need a battery or almost anything, these guys can help you at BNT Battery. And Howard's Glass Company with a new location, Highway 367 North, just down from George Kell Motor Company. They do windows, they do doors, glass, windshields. Give them a call at 523-3771. Brand Body Shop Collision of the Week coming up. And Subway Coaches Report.
Kicking off for the Bears will be number 17, that's Zach Brown. Back deep for the Greyhounds is number 10, Ben Collier. Along with number 22, that's Charlie Bell.
For Sub Sanders.
That's right. Sylvan Hills will kick off. Ben Collier, I think, deep this time, along with a little short kick over the middle. Be fielded by number 1 for Newport. That is Darren Moore, and he'll bobble it around and fall on it at about the 22-yard line. First and 10, Newport, from that point.
Once you bobble it right there, you have two choices. You say, well, I either fall on it and be safe and make sure we keep possession, try to pick it up. You have a lot of time to try to pick it up. Sometimes you don't know. You don't want to make a huge mistake right there. So probably pretty safe to fall on the football.
First and 10, Newport. Two receivers left, two right. Gunnar Bullard is your quarterback. Carl Turner, the running back. Give it to Carl. and just power running straight ahead. Nice first down gain again. Let's see where the spot is up very near the 30-yard line. Gain of 7 on the play, 2nd and 3, Newport.
That's just good hard running by Carl Turner. Pretty good job of the offensive line firing up.
We'll give it 6 yards on the play. That'll bring up 2nd and a short 4.
Maintain the boys right here and try to put some positives together here.
It's all about this drive right now. That's all you can think about. 2nd down and about 4. There's Carl, and boy, just played well by Sylvan Hills. They'll get pretty much nothing there. Ball down at the 30-yard line. It's going to be 3rd down and 3 for Newport.
13, Tyler Reeves for the Bears.
Third minimal gain on the under play. 10 minutes to play.
We're going to say that's going to bring up 3rd and about 3.
Charlie and Willis left. Throws over here to Elston. Incomplete, and Hounds will have to punt it, and that's what you did not want, a 3-and-out.
Well, a possession play there, and
Boys pass is handed for number 15, DeAndre Elston falls
in. DeAndre couldn't handle it.
And that'll bring up 4th and 3.
And Zach Alton will snap. Will Golden out this week with an illness. Good snap, rugby punt by Charlie, and that's a good one, but time for a return at the 35, 40, outside 45, up to the 48-yard line, 13-yard return, 1st and 10, Sylvan Hills at their own 48.
Punt was returned by number 7, Nathan Thomas for the Bears, tripped up by number 10,
Ben Collier. I don't know what you tell your defense, you just have so many weapons offensively, you just got to keep plugging, you just got to try, you just got to give all you've got.
48-yard line.
Robert Kendall's in the house.
Intercepted by Robert Kendall.
Yes, sir.
Intercepted by Robert Kendall.
Remember it well.
Doss straight back. He throws it over here. He's got a man 22. Big gain inside the 25-yard line.
Pass is complete to number 22.
Near the 21. Big gain for Sylvan Hills. First down.
Hounds came with some heat.
Look, that stop was made by number 25, Carl Turner.
Carl limps off.
Big gainer for the Bears. Good enough for a first down. Ball be spotted. 1st and 10 Bears.
Fast. They are fast.
How about the Greyhound? 22.
Nice. Heaps and hints a big hit for the Hounds. Big Jesse Simmons with the defensive play.
Pretty good job of penetrating by the defensive line. Getting in the offensive backfield.
Stuffed in the backfield by number 34, that's Denver Smith for the Greyhounds.
Merchants and Leonard Bank.
We'll say 4 yards on the play.
Second Hazel Street, M&PBank.com.
2nd and 14. Doss, again, straight back. Flushed out. Throws it deep, complete. He's a heck of an athlete, David Black.
Well, he just found a guy who had run one pattern one way and then came back and scrambled toward.
Stop was made by number 10, Ben Collier for the Greyhounds.
And just a sensational play. Just he kept that play alive, scrambling.
Like that ball will be spotted.
Had enough athletic ability to get away from the pressure.
What to say about the Greyhounds?
With 8:27 to play in the third quarter, these guys trying to go up more than the 28 they are right now.
Yeah. Motion. All hands off, and that little cutback again has been so successful, and they'll be near the 1 yard line. Be 2nd and goal for Sylvan Hills. The play's been so successful all night. This is pretty much everything they run.
Stop was made by number 62. Yeah. That's Jesse Simmons for the Greyhounds. Once they gain a 6 on the play, it'll bring up 2nd and goal from the 1.
off, and that's easy. 32 with another touchdown, and Sylvan Hills leads 41-7.
Tyler Davis taking it the final 1 yard. Touchdown, Bears!
41-7.
One more and the clock runs. Didn't want to talk about that, but that's the facts.
Point here, yeah, the facts are the facts.
Yeah.
Going to the sportsmanship rule, and that doesn't happen often against this Greyhound football team.
Very rarely. Except in there, it is good, and the clock, and no good.
Extra point attempt by number 17, Zach.
41-7, Sylvan Hills.
And with 7:42 left in the third, your score now.
I don't know whether I want him to hit it or not hit it.
Yeah, that's why I remain silent.
It's a learning curve.
Yeah, it
down
is.
Here tonight is a learning curve.
Hey, like, take this opportunity to remind everybody board. There's a fifth and quarter tonight at the
fairness,
Buffalo
Randy,
Wild Wings in Stillwood. After the game tonight,
game plan
again,
didn't work.
Yeah. Fifth quarter
it's just
at the Buffalo Wild Wings in Sherwood.
They're a little better
the
than we are.
They're just better, yeah. That's
they're
all you can say.
Better than we
probably the best team we'll play all this year, hopefully.
I think so, too.
Yeah.
Yeah, and it's not like you go, boy, we just played horrible and the penalties got us and we just, you know, we played horribly. I mean, it's not a matter of us playing horribly. What we did not so well is because of what they did well.
Yeah.
They made us look not too good. Because they are so good.
Kicking off for the Bears will be number 17, Zach Brown.
I don't know whether a championship caliber contender.
Back deep
I know
for the Greyhounds is number 22,
win
Charlie Bell. And number 2, Darren Garotti.
Charlie at the 15. Charlie 20. Running hard. Look at Charlie Bell play hard. What he just goes all out, David.
Well, it's that effort we're talking about in the first half. Every play is like that. He gives 100%. And, I never have been one of those to give 110 because I think it's impossible to give more than what you can give.
Yeah.
But he gives everything that he can give.
That stop was made by number 32, Fred Williams for the Bears. Like the Greyhounds will set up shop first and 10 at their own 39-yard line.
Carl back in the game, kind of limped off earlier, but he's back out there beside Gunner in the backfield. Gunner straight back, throws across the middle for DeAndre. Be incomplete. Makes it second down and 10. 7:25 to go in the third quarter. Hounds trail by 34.
DeAndre Elston
the coach tell me one time
three.
Wanted me to go.
And that'll bring
10%.
Up second and 10.
Talked about
impossible.
A math class, and they said, well, that doesn't work.
Impossible. Just give me 100.
You give me 100. Give me all you can get.
Fumble the football. And Sylvan Hills, well, it kind of bounced out of their hands, but I think they've got it. Yeah, Sylvan Hills has the football.
Covered by number 41, Jonathan Hicks for the Bears. It's like the Bears
that's
will set up shop
lose
first
a little concentration
10.
When you get down 41-7.
Just inside the Greyhound. 39-yard line.
What you talked about in halftime obviously hasn't worked. Well, you know, the coaches say, look, we got to come out here. We got to play, try to win this second half. And things haven't gone well for the Hounds right there, but that's just a concentration mistake right there. Everyone will be frustrated, not frustrated, but, you know, just you thought we had a football team that might be able to run the table. And you know what? You put this one behind you, and you get ready for a tough conference opener coming up this week.
That's exactly right. That's what your main goal anyway is that conference race. They got a new quarterback in, number 31. Hayden Schultz, Kyron, others on the tackle.
Was number 31,
up to the 35-yard line, gain of 4, second down and 6. We have 7:05 to go in this third quarter. Hounds trail 41-7.
Stop was made
if you're watching on Saturday morning, got some Pee Wee football going on out at legendary Greyhound Field on the new turf. Three games starting at 10, fifth grade, fourth grade, sixth grade, starting again at 10 against Harrisburg. Doss back in the game now. Thought maybe they were giving him the rest of the night off. And off to number 24, Big Jesse.
Was
throws him to the ground after a gain of 2. Brings up third down for Sylvan Hills.
Number 62,
third down and
for the Greyhounds.
Somewhere around 4, I think.
We'll say gain of a couple on the play. It's going to bring up third and a short 4.
6:13 clock moving. Third quarter, we trail 41-7.
Doss rolls, looks to pass, throws it deep. I think it's got a Sylvan Hills touchdown. No, it's incomplete and out of bounds.
He had it, he dropped it. Yeah.
Doss's pass intended for number two, Cameron Dews, falls incomplete. And that's going to bring up fourth and a short four.
Folks, if you have an automobile,
if I can have your attention,
automobile,
please.
Need to get rid of
it. Would Miss Donna K. Roark,
Ben Black, like
please report
to the
press box.
He doesn't handle any, you know, $10,000, $11,000, $12,000
stuff. Miss Donna K. Roark, would you please report to the press box?
You think that you want to sell, give Ben a call at 512-8429 and let him bring you some cash. He'll buy your automobile from you.
Fourth and three. Let's get a stop, guys. Come on. Doss drop, throws it. The man complete to number 11. He'll have a first down and more inside the 20-yard line up to the number 17. Be first and 10 in the red
Doss
zone for Sylvan Hills.
Complete to number 11, Elijah Batman Sourd for the Bears.
Think about that chicken at the Newport Food Mart's best in town.
Stop was made by number 10, Ben Collier for the Greyhound. That pass play was good enough for a fair first down.
Had a chicken breast.
Let the ball be spotted. First and 10 Bears. Just inside the Greyhound, 18-yard line.
At the Shell, right in front of my office, right across the street from Merchants and Planters Bank.
Hand off inside to 24. Denver Smith from behind and several others on the play. Short gain on the play for Sylvan Hills. Brings up second down and somewhere around 9, I would think, depending on the spot. 5:15 to go here in the third quarter. Hounds trail by 34.
Randy, our kids are still playing hard. Yeah. They're playing with effort. That's all you can ask for.
We'll say gain of maybe a yard on the play. It'll bring up second and 9.
Doss in that sweep around the right side. They'll have it inside the 10 to about the 8-yard line. That'll bring up third down and short. Third down and probably around 2.
Stop was made by number 39, Colton Willis.
Wilton Willis on the stop. Big Jesse limping off.
For the Greyhound.
Our trainer Zach Coyd had recently taped that lower left leg of his and see if that's the same problem. He's looking at it now. Doss keeps it. He'll have a touchdown. Made it look easy once again.
T.D. Doss, he's in. Touchdown, Bears!
7-7. Wow, wow, wow. Guys are pretty good.
Yeah, I never thought they'd be this dominant, but they are. We just haven't had the answer off defensively at all. And not enough points, obviously, offensively. Only one successful drive. We've moved the football to times, but just can't complete the drives. 4:11 to go here in the third quarter. Clock will run now. Kick looks good. It is good. Hounds battling to block that kick. Just can't quite get there. 48-7, Sylvan Hills. 4:11 to go in the third quarter.
You're scoring out the Sylvan Hills Bears.
Randy and I haven't even talked about this, but on Saturday morning, if you're watching on Saturday morning early, at 10 o'clock in the morning, we're going to have a legend in our office to do a little interview, and we're going to do a little different remember when for next month. Remember When program has basically been talking to folks who've lived in Newport for a long, long time and talked about Newport, so on and so forth. But Ricky Rowland, my friend Ricky Rowland from Tuckerman, had said he had a special guest and actually a friend of
Kicking off for the Bears is number 17.
And some Jimmy Valley is going to be in. He's going to be in the studio tomorrow.
For the Greyhounds is number
Saturday morning at 10 o'clock. And we're going to interview
with number two,
Jimmy, and talk
Aaron
about his
Roddy.
Legendary career. Been wrestling for 50 years. 50 years this guy's been wrestling.
In fact, he's 72 years old, right?
Absolutely.
Y'all have interviewed him before, haven't you?
Have.
I remember that,
A couple of occasions. And he really loves to come talk with Bud. And he always told Bud, he said, man, you need to be my tag team partner. He said, I got Big Bud as my tag team partner. he's a character to interview, but he's a real,
there is
he's a
cloth
very
on
good
the carpet.
Human being, a pretty good fella.
Yeah.
And I mean, if he's got his wrestling shoes on, so to say, so to speak, is, you know, when he talks like a wrestler, it's a little bit different. Then he's a down to earth, good human being.
Billy was the
I
ball
think
was
we'll see both sides of that.
That'll
be sometime next month ball when we get it on the air. Have some Jimmy Valiant in the house.
Be a great guest, yes, sir.
Rolling in the
TWA.
Man.
All the ladies, handsome Jimmy's on the way. Benny Smith alone.
That Memphis wrestling was just, that was the best ever,
yes, sir,
no doubt. Incredible wrestling.
Yes, sir. Saturday morning wrestling.
Ben Collier keeps it around the right side. Boy, just a big hit by the Sylvan Hills defense. Gain of about one on the play.
Ben Collier sweeps the Greyhound.
11 o'clock on Channel 5 every Saturday, man. You couldn't get any better than that.
No, sir.
We'll say gain of a yard on the play.
Best wrestler in the world.
Yeah, it's truly the best I've ever seen. Watched a lot of different, you know, networks and enterprises and things like that. That was always the best.
Yes, sir.
Second and nine. Gunner keeps it. Gunner cuts it up. Gunner with a big gain. Gunner still on his feet inside the 40, 35, past the 30, near the 29-yard line. Big gain, Gunner Bullard, first down in Newport.
Ball carrier was number four.
Well, that shows
Gunner
the effort
Bullard
that the Hams are still going to have.
Keeper for the Greyhound.
48-7.
Down by number four, James Waller.
And I think the clock's supposed to be running, and it's not. Was it?
Big gainer for the Greyhounds. That's good enough for a first down. Ball be spotted. First and 10 Greyhounds at about the Bears 28-yard line.
We're okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
We're 2-1 against 3-5A schools. I mean, that's not bad. We fumble it again. Gunner picks it up, and we'll be buried back in the backfield for a loss on the play.
Before Gunner Ford is sacked in the backfield by number 10, that's Hagan Jones. For the Bears. We'll say loss of about 7 yards on the play. That's going to bring up second and about 17.
Newport Technology Center, your Radio Shack dealer, Arkansas State University, Newport. ASUN.edu.
And off to Charlie Bell in the backfield. Charlie will get 2 yards to the 33-yard line.
Ball carrier was number 22, Charlie Bell.
Bring up third down and long
Greyhound.
For Newport.
An open field stop was made by number 41, Jonathan Hicks.
They haven't had a grand body shot collision of the week. They still got a quarter and a couple of minutes to try to find one.
Hopefully we'll get one.
All right, we'll say it gave him about a yard on the play. That's going to bring up
number five, Jay Cried in the game. The wide receiver to the left, along with number one, Darren Moore. Gunner fakes to Carl, in deep trouble, tries to get away.
There it is right there.
That was Deshaun Anderson, was it, in 57?
Yeah, grand body shot collision of the week.
Quarterback Gunner Bullard is sacked in the backfield. Finally wrestled down by number four, James Waller for the Bears.
Be fourth down and forever. Yeah, Deshaun. He was a help team player of the week a couple weeks ago.
Loss of about 5 yards on the play. That's going to bring up fourth and about 20.
48-7 with 1:18 and the clock moving.
Continuously. And Zach Alton to snap. Charlie to kick. McCabe Cordell, the up back, blocking. Snap is bobbled. Charlie's got time and he'll get it away. It's a pretty good hound roll and down at the 17-yard line. First and 10, Sylvan Hills from that point.
Punt is finally down by number 57.
And I don't think they'll get it spotted in time to run a play right here unless Sylvan Hills just wants to run one because they go fast.
For the Greyhounds, looks like the Bears will set up shop first and 10.
We will get Johnny Harrison after the game tonight. He comes
17-yard line.
I would say Doss is surely out by now. We'll see.
Yes.
Yeah, he is. Clock's at 5 seconds and counting, and they will run a play. And the quarterback keeps it around to the left, and he'll have a nice game. There was a flag thrown in there in the middle of the pile where you usually get a holding.
For the Bears, stop was made by number 34, Denver Smith. For the Greyhounds, there is fabric on the field.
fabric on the field.
Fabric.
He's enthusiastic.
He is. Procedure against Sylvan Hills. That'll be a 5-yard penalty. And that will be a mark off of 5 yards, and it will be the last play of the third quarter. We go to the fourth quarter with the Hounds trailing 48-7.
Randy, I'll tell you what I really miss. I miss Nanny's Bakery's butter rolls and apple fritters and donuts.
It'd be good on a Saturday morning,
oh,
I know that.
Wouldn't that be good?
That was some good stuff, man.
Yes, sir, it was.
Billy will cost the Bears and Abe Lincoln from the original line of scrimmage and bring up first and 15. And this will be an untimed down.
3 or 4 years. I really miss the, you know, you might have some extra. And of course, I hardly ever eat sweets during
the day. That will be the end of the quarter. That is the end of the third quarter of play. With your score, the Stonehill Bears, 48.
I might leave early on a Friday afternoon.
And the Newport Greyhounds, 7.
I might leave before then to get ready for the game.
At this time, we would like to take one last opportunity
butter rolls,
to give a special thank you to our great sponsors that have made our field facility improvement possible.
Oh, man, that'd be a good time, too. Yeah, Friday night or Saturday morning. It doesn't get any better than that, those times.
And First Arkansas Bank and Trust.
A lot of the fans.
Our track sponsor, Glenn.
Get home early tonight, yep.
Our legacy
sponsor. Bad trip down here on the interstate.
Yeah, it's pretty easy, absolutely. Not bad at all.
And State Representative Jim Nichols. Our Super Bears sponsor.
Boy, not a lot to talk about when you get behind 48-7. It's just play as hard as you can. And
except football.
Yeah.
Harrison Renshaw Physical Therapy and the Sylvan Hills High School Athletic Booster Club. Our Bear sponsors, Harco Construction.
Hard to talk when you can't think anyway because of the PA guy.
Sylvan Hills High School Band Booster Club. Once again, a great big thank you for your contributions to make.
First and 10, Sylvan Hills. This is the first play of the fourth quarter. Hand off inside. Again, we have a lot of second team reserves from Sylvan Hills in the game. Number 14 with a carry, a short gain on the play.
This guy is doing what he thinks is a good job, and there's no doubt. I mean,
ball carrier was number 14. That's Andre Collins.
I don't remember him being here a couple years ago, but he's enthusiastic.
Stuffed up at the line of scrimmage.
Kind of loud, and we just have to set it up underwear. There's a.
It's like no gain on that last play, and we do have an official timeout.
It really, really makes you appreciate a John Watson or Randy Klopechka doing the PA at our Newport games. It makes you appreciate
what we have. Once again, if I could have your attention, please.
A professional job.
With Miss Donna K. Rohrhardt.
That's just a different style of announcing.
Please report to the press box. Again, Donna K. Rohrhardt, would you please report to the press box?
Donna K., please come on up.
Please get up there so he doesn't have to announce it again.
We have a Greyhound down, I think.
Yep.
Or maybe is that a hound or is that a bear?
That's one of us. Like. Hopefully just a cramp, I think.
Well, I saw the guy in the blue shirt.
That's Zach Hoyt, our new trainer, Coach Harrison is tickled to death to have, and that does not look good. That is 49 Stafford.
Greyhound.
That's Karen. And you're talking about Gunner a while ago. That's what happens when you get in a game and it's lopsided and you still got a quarter to play. And you always have the risk of injury. Well, he's put in no weight whatsoever.
Does not look good.
Land. Yeah. Good enough, gracious.
And off up to about the 20-yard line. Sylvan Hills, 19, they'll call it.
For the Bears.
Several guys in for the Hounds defensively, I thought.
Stop was made by number 39. That's Colton Willis. For the Greyhounds,
Zach Alton in the game.
We'll say gain of about now 5 yards on the play. That's going to bring up third and about 10.
Well, Roddy defensively. Hayden. Maybe just a cramp there. Maybe just a Charlie horse on Karen.
Yeah, maybe that looks better. Yeah. A little more optimistic now.
Yeah, they're working on his leg. They wouldn't be working on it the way that they're working on it.
The running back comes around the right side. Lead down around the 23 or 24-yard line. It's going to bring up fourth down, and Sylvan Hills with their first punting situation of the whole game.
Number 21, that's Jordan Mabry for the Greyhounds.
And a unit that has not been out there, the Sylvan Hills punting unit, with 10:35 to go in the fourth quarter. DeAndre Elston will be deep for Newport, standing at around his own 45-yard line.
Still working on Kyron down here. I just think that's a plan. Huh?
Yeah, I think so. They, like I said, they wouldn't be doing that if it was something that we were concerned about earlier. Good snap. Good punt. DeAndre will just let it go. Takes a Sylvan Hills bounce inside the 30. Be down at the 27-yard line. First and 10, Newport, from that point. 10 minutes, and the clock is running continuously. We're in the fourth quarter, and the Hounds trail 48-7.
Looks like the Greyhounds will snap shot first and 10.
I'm just trying to remember sportsmanship rules against the Greyhounds.
My biggest memory is always that Osceola game. It was Osceola, or I think it was Osceola, where Mark Watley kept trying to walk away. That may have been Pocahontas that year. Yeah, I think that was Osceola and Mark Watley.
The official has to tell the head coach. And the official was trying to get a hold of Mark, and Mark walked one end of the sideline, and he walked the other end, and we saw the official.
Yeah.
If you don't tell the head coach, then you can't officially run the clock. Yeah. It's been a while, but I mean, sometimes it just happens.
Yeah.
Sometimes it just happens.
We've done it several times on the opposition. Bobble snap, that's Ben Collier. No, it's Julian Reed, Julian Reed at quarterback.
Number 8, that's Jordan Neal for the Greyhounds. Stop was made by number 43, that's Matthew Molin for the Bears.
Nice gain by Julian.
About 9 yards.
Gain of 9 on the play, second and one.
And one.
I hope you can't hear that.
Charlie Bell in the backfield with Julian Reed. We'll get these other guys as time goes along. Charlie tries to get outside, battling hard, and could have a first down with great second, third, and fourth effort. Could have been down back around the 30-yard line, but makes it to the 36-and-a-half, and I think he's got a first down. First down, Newport.
Matthew Molden, along with number 53, Eric Taylor for the Bears.
Charlie out.
That play was good enough for a Greyhound first down. Ball be spotted. First and 10, Greyhounds. Just shy of their own 37-yard line.
Ben Collier in the game in the backfield. Jordan Mabry at a wide receiver. And off to Ben Collier. Gain up to about the 40-yard line.
There was number 10, Ben Collier. Up.
Give him about three on the play. Down. Second down, Newport.
Stop was made by number 56, Marquelin Jones for the Bears.
Cable 15 TV.
About 3 yards on the play. It'll bring up second and 7.
Jackson's Funeral Home. Sponsors of Greyhound Football here on Cable Channel 15 TV. As is Modern Woodman, Brenda Benish, Norman Baker Pharmacy, the Harris Hospital, Greenway of Newport, El Puente Restaurant. And here's the next one.
And Dr. Ben Collier be stopped in the backfield for a loss of 3 on the play. Brings up 3rd down and 10 for Newport. The clock's inside 7 minutes. Again, we're continuously running.
Tripped up in the backfield.
Merchants and Planners Bank. L Flying Service, Farmers Tire Mart, Kelmore.
That stop was made by number 45, that's DeAndre Fuller for the Bears.
All of our regular Graham boosters.
Jay cried in the game at wide receiver. Jay was the help team player of the week for the past game.
About 4 yards on that play. That's going to bring up 3rd and about 11.
Julian keeps it to the right. Julian Reed running hard up to the 45-yard line. He'll be 2 yards short of a first down. It'll be 4th down, Newport. 4th and 2 from the 45. Good job by Julian.
Let me kind of give you an update here. I know that
we'll say gain of about 9 yards on the play. That's going to bring up 4th and about.
And one of the paramedics to come over to maybe look at Kyron. He's walking towards the Sylvan Hills sideline. Unreal.
4th and 2, Newport, 5:45 to go in the game.
See, our coaching staff say, come on over here, and the guy's over there, and he's saying, I got to go report in over here.
Good punt by Charlie. Gets a good bounce. Nobody deep, and it'll be inside the 10, bounded around the 7-yard line. Excellent punt by Charlie Bell. Be first and 10, Sylvan Hills from deep in their own territory. 5:19 to go in the ballgame. Hounds trail 48-7.
First and 10. What about their own 8-yard line?
It hasn't been a pretty match for the Newport Greyhounds, but nonetheless, you have to learn from this, and you got to move on. That's why they give you 10 games to play during the course of the year.
Newport gets more than 10.
Well, if you look at your list of goals throughout the season, one of those is to try to go undefeated. But that's the only one that will be scratched off the list as being unsuccessful in the year, because that's not going to happen. But that's not a major goal when you really want to have a deep run in the playoffs and play for a state championship.
Absolutely. Sylvan Hills goes wide, and boy, almost tackled in the back, in the end zone, and they will be. I think he barely got out of there. Almost a safety for the Hounds. I think he barely got out of there. McCabe Cordell is wanting the safety, but I don't think they're going to get it. Ball spotted right
14, Andre Collins,
about the 6-inch line.
Cleveland tacklers were led by number 21. That's Jordan Mabry.
Second down and long for Sylvan Hills.
Seven on the play.
Second and 17.
And 17.
Well, these paramedics are not in a hurry.
Well, they maybe have a safety there. Yeah, safety for the Greyhounds. Who made the tackle, David? Can you tell?
I can't see that far, but I'm looking on the bottom of the pile.
Quarterback number 20, Tyler Yeoman, is sacked in the backfield by number 34, Denver Smith. That will be a safety for the Greyhounds.
They say.
Yep, we'll give it to Denver.
Absolutely. I guess he gets 2 points, huh?
Absolutely.
All right, Denver.
I'm sure if he got any last year. He played fullback some, you remember, in the I formation. I think he did get a touchdown. So
yeah, probably a touchdown.
Not his first career points, first career defensive points for Denver. 48-9. Clock again continuously running. We're at 3:15 and counting.
The Newport High School cheerleaders. Oh, what a job that group does.
Great job. Yeah, absolutely. A lot of young ones on that squad. A lot of sophomores out there. Sylvan Hills have the option of kicking off or punting.
Result of the safety, the Bears will be kicking off from the 20. Kicking off for the Bears will be number 17, Zach Brown.
Zach Brown will kick off. 2:35 to go in the football game. Once again, 48-9 now after the Denver Smith
10, Ben Collier.
Safety.
22, Charlie Bell.
The next 3 weeks will tell us how good we're really going to be.
Yeah, absolutely. We'll learn a whole lot next week.
Absolutely.
Fielded by Charlie at the 36, and he'll just lay down on it. Be first and 10, Newport from the 36. We'll be inside 2 minutes when we snap it.
Ball is fell on by number 22, Charlie Bell, for the Greyhounds. Looks like they'll take over first and 10.
And we'll be interested to see Kyron's situation. They're over here working on him.
Well, they were trying to get a cramp out of his leg. And they are giving him an IV right now. Okay. Giving him out to get fluids in his body. If you can't get the cramp out, that's what you got to have. You got to have fluids.
First and 10, Newport from the 36.
Yes, there's a gate down there, Coach Black. Yes.
Hand off to Ben Collier. He'll pick up 2 yards to about the 38-yard line.
Kenny Black, Princeton Newport School.
Tristan Vance in the game for Newport, number 20 in the backfield. Devontae McCoy, number 13, is out there. Number one, Darren Moore.
Along with number 43, Matthew Molin for the Bears. Gain of a couple, bring up second and 8.
It's Tristan Vance, number 20 on the carry. Tristan will get, still running hard, up to about the 41-yard line. Give Tristan at least 3 on that play. Third down, Newport. One more play for the Hounds, more than likely. We're at 40 seconds and counting.
20, that's Tristan Vance for the
And Dan, get me the time, and we'll break for the coach to get here, and we'll call it a night for the broadcast.
We'll say gave him about 4 yards on that last
play. One more play. Third down and five.
Four.
Ball at the 41-yard line, 20 seconds and counting. Again, Julian Reed, Tristan Vance in the backfield. And Julian keeps it, tries to get outside, still battling hard. Look at Julian Reed battle. Good job, Julian Reed, playing hard. He'll have a Newport first down, and that's going to do it. Your final score, Sylvan Hills 48, Newport 9. Hounds go 2-1 in non-conference play.
And that is your ball game with the final score. The Sylvan Hills Bears 48 and the Newport Greyhounds 9.
A little business with Mike Brand.
Like to remind everybody,
and it's Hounds losing 48 to 9.
Tonight it's the Buffalo Wild Wings after.